Good morning, Davao. Good morning, Mindanao. Good morning, North, South, East, and West. This is Gilbert Lopez Martije Cacho. For the headlines, weather forecast, easterly is affecting Mindanao. Local news, free education access, quality enhancement. Revised liquor code aims to protect minors. 300 women availed of free cervical cancer screening. PUJ wrote to DFTC extended for farmers and consumers. National news. COMELEC leaves BSKE 2025 fate to Congress. Ombudsman orders filing of Grab case versus Duque Lau. International news. Israel order more evacuation as Rafah fighting intensifies. Maldives divisive campaign, rhetoric raises questions. Entertainment news. Famous artwork go on loan for first time on 200th birthday. This art exhibit shines the spotlight on artists who are mothers. Sports news. Terra Firma big man Isaac Go embraces challenge of facing San Miguel's 7-time MVP, June Mar Fajardo. England recover to trust Pakistan in first T20. Featured stories. A 3-day cameo trip into Scotland's sublime Borderlands. History Greek mighty Magulang is definitely mothering on TikTok. Side stories. Trivia. Do you know that Davao City is a gateway to the captivating landscapes of Mindanao? Weather forecast, Mindanao will be partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain showers or thunderstorms due to easterlies, possible flash floods or landslides during severe thunderstorms, light to moderate winds from east to northeast with light to moderate seas. Local news. An official from Commission on Higher Education Davao Region, Ched Davao, underscored that providing free and equal access to education for every student is the key focus of their new strategic plan for the academic years 2023 to 2028. Dr. Christopher Pio O. Pulido, Supervising Education Program Specialist of Ched Davao, discussed in a media interview on Friday morning, May 10, 2024, at the University of Southeastern Philippines YOSEP Gymnasium, the Commission's commitment to aligning with the President's vision and presenting their strategic plan to all higher education institutions nationwide. One of the primary objectives of this strategic plan is to ensure access and equity in education, particularly by eliminating fees for students in state universities and colleges. Additionally, the Commission aims to sustain the delivery of the quality education in the region, promote internationalization, and enhance Ched's corporate social responsibility in internal capacity as an institution. District Councilor Luna Acosta said that the amendment comprehensive liquor code of Davao City aims to limit children's exposure to alcoholic beverages. The ordinance approved for its third and final reading on May 7, 2024, includes provision to protect minors from early exposure to liquor. Acosta, chairperson of the Committee on Peace and Public Safety and a proponent of the ordinance, said during this I Speak Media Forum on Thursday morning, May 9, 2024, at the City Mayor's office, that the updated ordinance retains some original elements but incorporates new measures to safeguard minors from alcohol exposure. Acosta drew parallels to international practices where IDs are routinely checked during alcohol purchases. She acknowledged reports of liquors being served to minors in some establishment and stressed the importance of ID verification for customers and questionable age. Liquor selling establishments are required to display signage stating no liquors to minors, liquor last call by 12 a.m. and no liquor by 1 a.m. The signage must feature letters no less than 3 inches tall and be permanently positioned within the premises. Public parks and playgrounds are mandated to display signs prohibiting liquors and alcohol measuring at least 8 by 18 inches. A total of 300 women received free cervical cancer screening during the Cervical Cancer Screening Services regional launch at Davao City Recreation Center, formerly Almendra's Dream, on Thursday morning, May 9, 2024. Dr. Jolinda Acosta, Chief of the City Health Office, CHO, Technical Division of Davao City, said in an interview that more than 300 women aged 30 to 65 line up for the free cervical cancer screening through visual inspection with acetic acid or VIA. However, they can only accommodate 300 women for the screening. Thus, the excess number of women who were not able to avail of the VIA were offered free human immunodeficiency virus or HIV screening test instead. Acosta emphasized that the VIA service is conducted in partnership with the Philippine Obstetrical and Gynecologist Society. An official from Davao City Food Terminal Complex, DFTC, announced that they have successfully extended the jeepney route to improve accessibility for farmers and consumers to reach the terminal. Josephine Martin, officer in charge of DFTC, shared during the I Speak Media Forum on Thursday morning, May 9, 2024, at the City Mayor's office, that their request to extend the jeepney route to DFTC in Barangay Dalyaw, Turil District, Davao City, has been approved by the Land Transportation and Franchising Regulatory Board, Davao Region, LTFRB, Davao, and the City Transport and Traffic Management Office, CTTMO. Martin underscored the challenge of attracting consumers who prefix existing facilities but emphasize ongoing efforts to enhance the establishment. Currently, the FTC offers cold storage facilities and various machineries donated by the Department of Science and Technology, DOST. The DFTC is awaiting approval for operation is its cold storage and setting its rates. Martin noted that several businesses have expressed interest in utilizing the cold storage services. National News. The Commission on Election, COMELEC, said Friday, May 10, 2024, that it is leaving the decision to lawmakers whether to push through or postpone the December 1, 2025 Barangay and Sangguniang Kabataan Election, BSKE. In a phone interview, COMELEC Chairman George Garcia said, "It is entirely up to the Congress if it will postpone the BSKE to October 26, 2026, as proposed in House Bill 10344. He stressed that the commission will only be involved once the bill is signed into a law by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. The Office of the Ombudsman has ordered the filing of GRAP case against former Department of Health DOH Secretary Francisco Duque III and former Procurement Service PS Department of Budget and Management DBM Executive Director Lloyd Christopher Lau. The case stemmed from the alleged irregularities in the DOH transfer of 41.4 billion funds to PS DBM for the procurement of medical supplies at the height of the COVID-19 pandemic in 2020 and 2021. Complainants in the case were former Senator Richard Gordon and Senator Risa Hontiveros, who spearheaded the Senate investigation on the COVID-19 supplies procurement after it was plugged by the Commission on Audit, COA. International News. Israel has told 10,000 more Palestinians to leave Rafah as it intensifies military operations in southern Gaza. Flyers dropped from the air and posts on social media told residents in the city eastern district to go to Al-Mawasi, a narrow coastal area which Israel calls an expanded humanitarian zone. Parts of the Rafah where the streets were packed with locals and displaced people just days ago now look like a ghost town. Israel has said it will proceed with planned operations in Rafah despite of US and other allies warning that the ground offensive could lead to mass civilians casualties and a humanitarian crisis. Image shows smoke rising over the city on Saturday and witnessed, quote by AFP, reported airstrikes near the crossing with Egypt. Posting on X, formerly Twitter, the Israel Defense Forces IDF said that during the past days, troops had been engaged in face-to-face battles with Hamas fighters in Rafah. In the lead-up to India's general election, Narendra Modi was expected to frame it as a referendum on his decade as prime minister. He was expected to boast about achievements like generous welfare programs and space flights. He was reaffirmed that the new Ram temple in Ayodhya represented a cultural assertion for India's majority Hindus. Even foreign policy was anticipated to influence the ballot, with a publicity boast afforded by Mr. Modi's hosting the G20 summit last September. Opinion polls have predicted a third record equaling landslide win for his Bharatiya Janata Party, BJP. But early in the grueling 6-week election, Mr. Modi's campaign shift gears, using divisive rhetoric that has raised questions about the tactics. He's been accusing the opposition, led by the Congress Party, of appeasing the Muslim minorities community. Muslim makes 14% of India's more than 1.4 billion people, taking a cue from Mr. Modi's campaign. Social media posts by the BJP have, according to the opposition, demonized Muslim. Entertainment news. The National Gallery has sent some of its finest masterpieces around the UK to mark its 200th anniversary. 12 famous artworks, including Constable, the Hay Wayne, Botticelli's Venus and Mars, and Rainier's The Umbrellas, have traveled across the UK. Simultaneously, exhibition opened on Friday at 12 institutions, putting more than half of the population within an hour of one of the masterpieces. Some of the paintings have never been loaned by the gallery before. The 95 million euros bicentenary plans also include a blockbuster Van Gogh shows, the creation of a new digital gallery, a UK road trip of art workshop, and a refurbishment of the National Gallery site at London's Trafalgar Square. This Mother's Day, an art exhibit titled Woman I Am will showcase the works of artists who are moms at the Art Tablado Robinson's Gallery until May 15. Since 2020, Art Tablado, a Robinson's Land initiative, has been supporting Filipino artists by providing them with venues so they can bring their art closer to people. In the past years, Art Tablado, a portmanteau of the words art and entablado, has featured artists both rising and established at its art stage in Robinson's Galleria, Robinson's Antipolo, Summit Ridge, Tagaytay, and Crown Plaza, Galleria, Manila. This time, artist mother takes center stage in an exhibit organized by Valerie Teng and Mylene Cueto. And for the sports, Isa Akgo appeared extra motivated whenever he goes up against Junmar Pajardo of San Miguel. If you aspire to be great, you have to go after one. Such was Tira Firma big man Isa Akgo's mindset, especially when squaring up against San Miguel counterpart, seven-time most valuable player Junmar Pajardo, before carving a legend that will forever endure. Even former Chicago Bulls superstar Michael Jordan had to dethrone the likes of Isaiah Thomas and Magic Johnson in the NBA. England recovered from a shambolic start to beat Pakistan by 53 runs in the first T20 at Ed Baston. The hosts slipped to 11-4 inside the first three overs before Heather Knight and Amy Jones led a fight back to post 163-6. Knight scored 49 and Jones 37 in a fifth-week stand of 67 before Daniel Gibson. Entertaining 41, not out from 24 balls, provided a late boost. In replay, Pakistan squandered a positive start with England leg spinner Sarah Glenn's 4-12, sparkling a drastic collapse from 66-2 to 110 all out. The visitors finished the power play in 57-2 in comparison to England 29-4 before their middle order fragility was ruthlessly exposed. Glenn bowled beautifully, supported by seamer Lauren Bell's 322, as England expertly closed out of dominant victory. But their early batting collapsed silence, and Edgbaston crowd of 12-241. Featured stories. The first official canoe trail in the south of Scotland just launched, covering a 30-mile stretch of the majestic River Tweed. The River Tweed doesn't just run through the Scottish borders region. In its lower reaches, the river itself forms the border the Anglo-Scottish divide, tracing the twists and turns up Tweed for 17 miles. This has loosely been the case since the Battle of Carham in 1018, where Malcolm II of Scotland defeated Alfred, the English ruler of Bamborges. It has legally been the case since the Henry III of England and Alexander II of Scotland. Battles have been won and lost in that time, but the border hasn't budged much since. A mother knows best, and in the case of content creator Mona Magno Veluz, history as well. The self-confessed history geek, more popularly known as Mighty Magulang, has been active in releasing bite-sized videos to inform netizens about genealogy of Filipino history on social media platforms like TikTok and YouTube. On TikTok alone, she has almost 500,000 followers, while her most popular video has over 3.3 million views. Veluz said she started uploading videos on TikTok during the pandemic as part of the wave of trends for Filipinos who were stuck inside their homes. Her idea is simple: talk about history and genealogy, which she has several resources. For the side story, let's watch this. And for the trivia, do you know that Davao City is a gateway to the captivating landscapes of Mindanao? From the enchanting Lake Cebu to the majestic Mount Hamigitan, there are endless destinations to explore beyond the city limits. That's all our news for today. Please like, share, subscribe, and click the bell button for you to be updated of the Pinoy Rabs news. This is Gilbert Lopez Martí Cazzo. Good morning.